Welcome to Dual Economics. It's hot as a outside. Cursive here, one half of Dual Economics. This is not financial advice. I am not a financial advisor. But in order to know what's going on, a conversation needs to be initiated. Today, I want to do a quick rundown and explain the recent SEC versus Ripple case and its significance to the entire crypto space. Shout out to the Bit Squad. Shout out to Bit Boy. We still throwing it down. It's up. Throw it up. We still throwing it up. The entire cryptocurrency industry has been calling for regulation to better provide clear rules for coins. And the recent ruling of XRP not being a security amplifies the attention of Congress to clarify the status of crypto assets. All right. Let's begin. What is Ripple? Ripple is a payments company that specializes in cross-border remittance. The company does this by leveraging blockchain technology. The company also leverages the XRP token. XRP uses the Interledger standard. This is a blockchain protocol that aids payments across different networks. For example, XRP's blockchain can connect the ledgers of two or more banks. This effectively removes intermediaries and the need for centralization in the system. XRP seeks to provide a better alternative to Bitcoin with faster and more efficient transactions. Their goal is to create a digital asset that is more sustainable and built with specific use case of payments to take over the world. All right, I don't get it, Ripple. Yep. And then this guy shows up and start knocking. Like, I got going on, man. You know, when he come and knocking, you know what he looking for. That's Gary Gensler, man. You need some money. I'm listening, looking at him. Anyway, Ripple raised over $1.3 billion by unloading XRP tokens in 2013. The SEC said Ripple never filed a registration document, which is mandatory for companies in the stock market to raise funds. An unregistered securities offering is an offer and sale of a security that is not registered by the SEC. The Securities Exchange Commission sued Ripple in December 2020. For those that don't know, the SEC is a United States government oversight agency responsible for regulating the securities market and protecting the investing public. Good job. Many question the protecting the investing public part because of the intentional lack of regulation and incompetence due to the Celsius debacle and FTX scam. Yeah, we all know how that went down. Allegedly, sales of XRP performed by Ripple was considered by the SEC an unregistered securities offering. An unregistered securities offering is an offer and sale of a security that is not registered by the SEC. Coinbase and many other crypto exchanges began to delist XRP from their exchanges, causing a huge downside in the price of XRP and its market cap. During the Bitcoin bull market of 2020, within 4 days of the lawsuit, the price of XRP fell 63%, destroying $16 billion of market cap. At that time, the market cap was about $28 billion. So that was a huge, huge downtrend. I think we all remember that. The SEC deemed many cryptocurrencies, including XRP, as securities. You know, that's a security. I hate the word security. A security is a financial instrument traded in financial markets that represents ownership or debt in a company or government entity. When you own a security, the holder has certain rights, such as interest, dividend payouts, or future growth capital. The SEC determines whether or not certain transactions qualify as investment contracts through the Howey test. If it passes, transactions are considered securities and must heed to certain registration requirements and distinct disclosures. The Howey test has four prongs: an investment of money, which is pretty much self-explanatory. You're investing your money. Two, in a common enterprise, which takes on three approaches. The first, the horizontal approach, which centers on the idea that all the investors are putting their money towards the same enterprise. The second, the vertical approach, which is an investment where the success of the investors is connected to the success of the entity that is being invested in. And the third, the broad vertical approach, which is an investment that hinges on a promoter or a third party's knowledge. And the third, with the expectations of profit or an investor's drive or reason for buying said asset. Is the investor trying to turn a profit or store wealth? If it's the opposite, then that said asset checks as a security. If it's the latter, likely it will be considered as something totally different. So USDT Tether, for example, would be considered as a digital dollar versus it being labeled as an investment contract. Now, if that USDT is earning interest, that is where questions start to arise. And finally, to be derived from the efforts of others, which puts a barrier between the third party and the investor. If the investor has a positive impact on the investment, it's likely not considered an investment contract. As a final result, on July 13th, 2023, while Ripple did not violate securities laws when selling XRP on exchanges, the judge ruled that the company did violate these laws when selling the tokens to institutional investors. So in other words, not only the sale of the XRP token on exchanges, but all cryptos sold on exchanges are considered not securities. And the SEC and Gary Gensler have no jurisdiction over them. Just stick to the traditional finance, Gary. Just stay in your lane, partner. Okay, so what impact does this ruling have on crypto, you might ask? Well, we already know this ruling does not affect Bitcoin because it does not pass the Howey test. Chair Gensler is recorded saying Bitcoin has never been a security. Ethereum, however, there is somewhat of a gray area about whether it is a security or digital commodity. Gary Gensler has been on record dodging questions on whether or not Ethereum is a security, specifically when testifying to the Financial Service Committee back in April. You should have heard him. It was insane. The recent ruling of XRP could possibly raise assumption that Ethereum may be viewed as XRP being not a security. What is important to remember, though, from this ruling is the way in which their offerings were initially issued. If the allocations were sold directly to the public, then said cryptocurrencies could be labeled as securities. Initial offering transactions could possibly be separately regulated versus those made through exchanges. So make sure to check and research token allocations and tokenomics when building positions in different coins. The SEC continuously points out how many crypto startups are undermining traditional finance systems by avoiding being regulated. This is a major win for Ripple, don't get me wrong, and the space in general, but we all know there is a need for transparency, regulation, and protection to avoid scammers and ill-willed actors. I mean, come on, there needs to be some kind of regulation. But he don't want to do it. He don't want to do it. So I hope this video was helpful. Please like, subscribe, and share. And thank you to all the viewers that took out their time to watch. Dual Economics, thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next videos.